Welcome at Kempers Watersport. Today we're extremely fortunate to be out on a beautiful day with fantastic weather. We have close to 20 degrees. It is really nice and quiet, and we were taken to this Kempers Island with this fantastic Axopar 37XC/cross cabin. As I mentioned, this is Kempers Island, which is a great place at Westeinder Lake, a beautiful area. This island actually is owned by Kempers Watersport, and some of our clients use it, and I use it personally. A great place and an ideal place to moor up this beautiful Axopar and go through it. So I'd like to welcome you on board. This is a brand new Axopar 37XC, as I said. The new Axopar 37 was introduced as the Revolution during the Düsseldorf Boat Show last January. I have been driving several Axopar 37s, I think it was November last year, in Finland. Quite different conditions. I think it was close to or slightly below 0 degrees even. So again, we're really happy that we have this fantastic weather today and to be able to show you this Axopar 37 cross cabin. Some of you may know or have seen our other videos of the previous version of the Axopar 37. I won't go into all the differences because I personally think that this is just a great matured boat. And a lot of things of course have changed, but in general I think the ergonomics have improved enormously. And as usual, I'd like to start at the bow, where we have of course the anchor, which is an option, and this place to store all the anchor gear. And this particular owner uses it also to store different things such as fenders, cleaning stuff. And as you see, some small details have again improved, where you have the water filler cap here now, which I think is a small detail, but it all comes down to the addition of all these small details. This no longer is in the deck. Of course, this is more sheltered, and also it's just nicer when you're on bare feet like I am now, that's not something to stumble over. This is an extra control for the anchor winch. There's a remote inside, which is wireless, by the way, so you can take it with you. You can also control the optional bow thruster. A really big anchor locker, lots of space to store all your fenders. There are 6 on board this boat, and there's plenty of room to do this. And of course, the anchor winch is below deck. Notice also the stainless steel gas struts. All these details so that the water that pours down doesn't go into the anchor locker, so that everything's wet there. It's just made in a way that it's all sheltered, protected, and the water is guided in a way so that everything stays dry. You probably have noticed that this is all powder coated in black. That is because this Axopar 37 is a Brabus line version, where you get all the railings, the cleats, and items such as these, which are for the sun awning in the bow, in black. It's all powder coated. And also the mast, the targa mast, is powder coated in black. And there are some other details which I'll come back to later. A nice stainless steel anchor, LED navigation light in the bow, and of course, practical non-skid area. This is a great step on, so very practical. This particular customer chose to have this layout, which is an option. Well, I should say that the table and this bow cushion here are an option. And in this way, this is just a great place to sit down and socialize. It's not huge, but it's big enough to seat, I think, 4, maybe even 5 people. And a very nice social area, especially when it's extremely warm, when you have the sun awning out and you can enjoy a light drink or something here. Just a great place to sit down and look around you and have fun. There is another alternative. Of course, standard, you only have this. And again, the bow cushion is an option, the table is an option, but you can also have a small, extended sofa, I would call it here, with extra storage below, so that you can have your feet in a lounge position, your legs in a lounge position. Unfortunately, those two options do not come together, because then this area comes too close to the table. So it's either or. So either this setup or the lounge area where you have the extended base here with additional storage. There's deck lights. Of course, there's this to attach a lifeline. The area here being less high than there, which is in fact extremely high, so it just feels extremely safe being here. I think this is a great safe way to go to walk from the bow to the aft, or vice versa. And of course, something I haven't mentioned yet, are these great gullwing doors. I'm taking a moment to particularly pay attention to this great new option. I personally think it is a fantastic feature. They open as easy as I'm doing now, and the good thing to it is that it gives you so much more possibilities to enjoy the boat on a beautiful day such as today. Imagine it's early spring now, I'm sure around 6 o'clock late in the afternoon it'll get chilly. What you could do is just open these up, sit down there, so that you're sheltered from the wind, the chilly wind, but you still have the outside feeling. And also, it's an easy access to things that you may have stored here, an easy access to the toilet area below. So I really like this feature. Before I go inside, I'd like to take you aft. Let me just close this. I'll leave that open for now. And going all the way to the aft, again, the freeboard is extremely high on this boat, which gives a very safe feeling. And this boat has the optional aft cabin package, which not only gives you extra space to sleep on the boat. I'll show you inside, there's a huge aft cabin, but I still like this great area to do some lounging. I am 1.92 meters, as a lot of people know in the meantime, but it's, well, long enough, it's even more comfortable like this. But it's a great place to sit, and again, you can also have a sun awning here. This owner also chose to have it, that is why you again see these in powder coated in black, where you have the supports here, and it goes all the way from the top roof like this. So if it's an extremely warm day, this is a great place to sit down, do some lounging, and enjoy the sunshine. This area is also a great place to do some bathing. The swimming ladder is, I think, on this side. Yes, it's here. So this is a standard grab-on. So that if you come out of the water, it's easy to get out. And I would always recommend this ski pylon, which is of a really large diameter. But not only that, it is just another way of grabbing on. So that if you step on a low pontoon, from a low pontoon at this side, you have something to hold on to. But also if you come out of the water, you can grab on easily. As an option, which this owner didn't choose to have, you can have a full bathing ladder on this side with a longer grab-on. We may implement a short photo or rendering of this possibility. I think it's nice, very practical at least. And this owner chose to have the twin Mercury V8 300 engines installed. Great engines, but of course I'm going to take out this boat for a spin later on. And he also chose to have the joystick piloting option. So these are joystick steered engines. What else do I need to tell you here? Well, of course, there's also another possibility here on the after two sides to attach a lifeline. Huge storage with these flush hinges. This, of course, is all stainless steel, 316. Again, a stainless steel gas strut. Nice gunneling so that this remains dry. We as Campers Watersport installed the shore power on this boat. That's because this owner also wanted an inverter. And now the shower, which is also an option, is installed here. Again, keeps the boat nice and clean. So there's nothing to bump into or damage or anything. Again, ergonomics, I think, are fantastic on this boat with these nice rounded edges. It's just being around and on boats a lot, you notice that this has been developed by people who have lots of experience in boating because the ergonomics are fantastic. And I'm around boats many, many times and I have seen different things, but this is truly fantastic with regards to the ergonomics, but also there's a lot of other things which I personally like. Let me take you inside. Going here, you may notice these huge opening doors. They slide easily. I mean, it's as simple as this. I always recommend using this in nice weather because if you stop the boat from planing, they tend to slide forward because they go so easily, they close so easily. But this also adds to the outside feeling. A lot of people who come and see us in the showroom, they come for the open, the spider version or the suntop. The same applies to the 28 range. But going further down the road in the process of buying a boat, some people experience that this cabin version basically is a two-boat boat. And what do I mean by that? On a beautiful day such as today, it is like an open boat. If you open these big sliding doors and the roof like we did just now, it feels like you're on an open boat. And the good thing to it too is that when you're done boating, you don't have difficult canopies with all kinds of supports that you need to close with lots of zippers, nothing. It's just a matter of pressing the button like this. And the roof closes, you close the doors. There's just one simple cover going over as an extra protection on this roof. And that's it. So it's really simple. Again, I'd like to take you inside. Here inside, there's a nice setup with this beautiful L-shaped sofa. Two doors here for the captain and the co-pilot, I would say. A great position to be. And again, here the ergonomics are fantastic. I'm at the right place, standing like this, but you can sit down comfortably. And the angle of these controls are perfect. The place of the joystick steering is perfect. The controls of the bow thruster are on the right position. The same goes for the trim tabs. There's additional storage here. There's a footrest. You may notice that this is exactly giving me the opportunity to sit in the correct position with a nice high backrest, even supports for your armrest, for your arms. So armrests, a great position. And this can be tilted. This, by the way, is a Brabus Line detail with the B logo, which is also here, the Brabus engraved with this nice suede feeling stitched steering wheel. These are the controls for the heating unit, which is an option. I have found it to be extremely comfortable and powerful. We have been driving this boat in a lot lower temperatures, but we could just make this boat very comfortable by using the heating, even in the lowest possible position. And also the place for the blowers against the front shield is fantastic. I mean, even if you don't need the heating unit because it's quite comfortable, sometimes if a boat, if you drive it and you start breathing inside the boat, you have slight moisture against the front shield, just turn on the heating for a few moments only and it blows away. Very, very practical, very comfortable, and it adds to the safety. This boat has been installed, has the new glass display, I would like to call it, installed, a great solution, but I'll come to that later. And going forward, of course, before I do that, this can be closed like this. And a nice gas strut here. And this particular boat does not have the optional toilet compartment. The toilet is below here. I think it's a great solution because it's a really nice open area like this. But of course, in different areas or in different families, people may want the toilet compartment where you have a door approximately here, which is a glass door, and the toilet is on this side with even an optional shower on that side. This is an option, this sink faucet with a small cupboard below. This customer chose also to have the comfort package, but we still need to install the cushions because this is one of the very first that needed to go to a boat show. So there were some things that we as a dealer still need to install. You see the cushions there. That all is for the comfort package. Practical steps here. You fold this up while you sleep so you don't hit your head while sleeping. But they are very comfortable or practical to step outside. A lot of light here inside. But there's also a cover for the gullwing doors, so you can add... Well, you can provide for some privacy in the front cabin. There's indirect lighting here and here. There's extra lights here. Just a very, very nice area. There's lots of headroom here. Of course, it's not big enough to stand up on your as tall as I am. Long beds, they're wide. Plenty of place with even places to put your drinks here. Just a great area. Some people may notice this small detail. This is something that we installed as Campers Watersport. As an option from Axopar, you can get a shore power installation with a battery charger. But this owner wanted to have the possibility to use his Nespresso coffee machine. So he wanted 230 volts while being on board. And that's why we installed a Victron inverter slash charger combination, with this display here now showing 12.9 volts. There's a lot of things you can show here, but I'll show you later, because the good thing now is also that it can be shown on the digital dashboard. These are fuses, automatic fuses, a small mirror there, and I think I've covered everything in the bow area. So let's go aft, where you can fold up the aft seat to go into the aft cabin. This goes really easily. I'll step aside. A very roomy aft cabin. Now the blinds have not been installed yet on this boat, but there's plenty of room. And I always tend to show how long it is. Again, I'm 1.92 meters. Let me use this side because there's something on this side. If I put these aside, you can see that this is over 2 meters. Way over 2 meters. Plenty of room. I still have about this much, and I'm even not fully to the bottom end there. We installed a digital multi-control, so you can also control the inverter and the battery charger from here. There's a USB port, twin one, also on the other side. There's a 230 volt socket. Just a great place. And of course, there's also a possibility to have the warm air go through the aft cabin by opening this here. Of course, grab rails on the right places like this. And if you do sit down and you want your legs to be comfortable, you can fold this down and have your feet rest on this footrest. cup holders here on this side, and also, let me close this quickly, and also behind here. Some people who look at the details may notice these have been installed by us for the coffee machine of the owner, so that he can use the coffee machine with the socket here. But again, cup holders, tinted windows, by the way, and I really like this huge folding table. Again, I'm not the tallest guy, but I'm 1.92 meters, and you can see that this can easily, well, I think have even 4 to 5 people here, and you can actually turn this seat here. You could also turn this, but if you turn this, you could even add one person, and this can be turned, and you may wonder that if you turn it, there's no place to put down your feet, but if you turn it around, this is a great place in the evening when you want to read a book and you put your feet here. There's a huge storage area below this cushion here. And I think with that, there's this refrigerator. I personally think it's kind of small, but Oxapar told me that they're still looking into another possibility for this. There's a fire extinguisher, by the way, here and also outside. So, and of course, grab rails, this place there. So again, really good ergonomics. But I think it's time to start her up and take her out for a spin. I have already taken down a few fenders and some mooring lines, but while I was halfway, I thought, well, I might as well just show you a really good feature of the joystick piloting system. We're on a really small area here. This is a small sheltered inner lake. And let me take the boat to a full stop like this. One feature I particularly like is the skyhook feature. If I engage it now, you'll see a warning on the screens here. The boat stays on this position. This is done with the GPS and the twin engines, which turn, they go forward, they go aft. It is done what is necessary to hold the boat on the exact position with a margin of, I think, 2-3 meters or so. And this, I think, is a great feature because it gives me the possibility to very quietly just prepare or take down the fenders, the mooring lines, without having to look around you every second if everything's okay. I mean, I of course have checked the area. There's no boat close by. So it gives me a really comfortable way of taking down the fenders and storing them in the bow area here. So again, the boat is in the skyhook position, giving me the possibility to do this without being worried and without having to rush. Still, it's in exactly the same position, so I'm slowly walking back, going to the wheel. I just press a button, the skyhook feature. You may notice that this has this bluish light now and it's blinking, so that it's showing that it's engaged. If I take it off like this, it's green, which means I have to confirm that I'm taking over now, which means that I am now taking over the boat and I can use the throttles like this. But of course it has the joystick installation also. So if I just pull it sideways, and the further I push it, the stronger it goes, the boat goes sideways. So it means that it is a very intuitive system. People with not so much boating experience can drive a boat like this. And I can do this and turn the boat 360 degrees. I'm giving it a strong force now because, of course, we don't have all the time in the world. So it may look a bit rough, but you get the idea. And of course, there's an autopilot integrated with the system also. It is quite costly. Here in Holland, it is around 26,000 euros, including VAT, which is a lot of money, to be honest. But to my experience, the 37s, which we've sold also of the previous generation, people were hesitant to order it because, again, it's a lot of money. But when they did, they were very happy with it because it's ease of use, it's also added safety, I personally feel, because if the skipper has a personal injury or something happens and can no longer drive the boat, there's always someone on board who can very intuitively take the boat into a mooring. So again, I really enjoy this feature, the joystick piloting. And of course, there's an autopilot integrated, which is a very nice thing if you drive long distances and you want to have the boat remain, stay on its course, and heading wherever you're heading to. So let me take her out. Of course, it's always difficult on a boat. I have to be careful here because there's a workboat with only a small area to go through. Let me see if we'll manage that. I think we'll manage going very slowly. This is quite a test, by the way. Let me put the bow thruster on just for safety. I have to watch the branches here. Hoi, goedemiddag. Rust is alles, hè?
Zeker, hè?
Heerlijk. You may notice these two screens that they are now in a certain setup. I have put this on the 3D setup of the chart option. I personally like this, especially with the satellite overlay. But you'll notice that I installed it in a way that it has the satellite overlay only on land, which gives us this really clear look. And I have my glasses on. It's not so very common that you can use and see these screens clearly with sunglasses on, especially when they're polarized glasses, but I can clearly see these. So I really like these Simrad screens. They're 12-inch screens. This is the most expensive navigation option you can choose from Axopar, but I would always recommend this. Especially now with this new Axopar software. And while I'm talking, let me close the roof because I think it's better for you as a viewer to see these screens when I have the roof closed. And I can also take my sunglasses off, which makes it a bit more personal. Let me close this roof in the meantime. Sorry, door. Okay, here we are. So this is the Axopar software. And there are several options. I made a separate video in Düsseldorf on this software. So I'm just giving you a short, really short glimpse of what is possible. This is the boat status with fuel, service battery status. You can do a checklist, you can do a trip. And while driving, there are two modes, a sports mode and an economy mode. I tend to use the economy mode because it gives you the possibility to drive at a certain RPM / speed with which you have the longest range. And I'll come back to that later. And I'm showing this on this screen. You can have it on two screens. Of course, there's also the option to have, which I'll quickly show, other things such as the downscan, which is installed on this boat. You can see now that the water is 11.6 degrees, by the way. And also, and that is something that we as Kempers Watersport installed, you can see the Victron installation with the inverter now being on. You can see what the capacity is, how strong it's loading. There's 14.5 volts, so it's charging via the alternators of the engine. So a really nice setup. Let me take it down to the Axopar setup. Of course, you can have the simple engine setup if you want to just see all the engine data. But again, I'm taking it back to the Axopar software. I just forgot to mention that what Axopar did really good, I personally think, is install these remote main switches. There are four. And this prevents you from having to go down the aft cabin, going around the corner and turning the main switches. This is just hassle-free. You come on board, you open the door, You put on these main switches and you're off. It's as simple as that. Again, ergonomics are fantastic on this boat. I'm leaning while we speak like this, but if you sit down like this, I did already put this seat in my ideal position. And these armrests are just great. And you'll notice now that I have this setup in a way that you can see here, the Eco GPS. We're now doing 0.6 kilometers per liter of fuel. And here you can see that we're doing 3.1 liters per nautical mile. But this figure, of course, is interesting if you want to use your fuel in the optimal way. And to my surprise, I have found that the cruise speed of this boat is actually really high. And what Axopar has done really well is that they have improved the efficiency of the hull in a way that, in combination with new V6 or V8 engines of Mercury, it is an extremely efficient hull. And what I mean by that is that the fuel efficiency has improved from the previous model, which was already, I would say, class leading, but now it's even better. And taking up the speed, we're doing 35 kilometers an hour, 40. And you'll see if I let go of the controls, this comes down to 0.6, sorry, 0.5. And we're doing 48 kilometers an hour, or 26 knots approximately, which is already quite fast. And if I take the speed up a notch, you'll see that after the acceleration, it's not so different. I mean, it's 2.6, 2.5. 0.5, and we're doing close to 60 kilometers an hour, 58 to be exact, 31.3 knots, 2.5 liters per nautical mile. And this is really fantastic. To my knowledge, there's no other boat in this class which drives like this, going really fast. 60 kilometers an hour is quite fast as a cruising speed, but I will take her up. But there's no boat who has this fuel efficiency. Notice this 3D chart setup, which I particularly like. Of course, you can zoom in and zoom out. And with the Platinum Plus charts from Navionics, you get this overlay, this satellite overlay option. But of course, there are several options. And in the meantime, let me take her up to about 70 kilometers an hour. Some time. 2.9 liters per nautical mile, which is still really, really good for a boat. 2.8, it's going down slightly, which is going extremely fast. Being very comfortable, I can engage the autopilot like this. Of course, I would not recommend people doing this in a small sheltered lake like this, but it's just to show that it drives really comfortably. I can still talk with other people on board and enjoy the boating. I have to confirm that I'm taking the autopilot off. And while doing this, let me take her up to top speed. I think we managed to do 88 kilometers an hour a few days ago. 85. 46 knots. Let me turn around. I don't have enough space here. Driving really comfortably like this. I'm not doing really short turns because of the camera. But trust me, it can handle really, really tight curves extremely well. I have noticed that people are testing different propellers. On this boat, we do not have the optimum propellers for the top speed. because I think you can reach speeds of over 19 kilometers / around 50 knots. We're doing 87 kilometers an hour as we speak, which is, I think, extremely fast for a 37 foot boat. But if you spend some time testing the optimal propellers, you may even get her up to 90 kilometers an hour. Okay. I really like this boat. It's really one of the nicest boats I've ever driven. I've taken her out on the IJsselmeer in quite rough conditions, but I really loved it. And please also watch my other videos driving her in Finland, because then you get some of the idea of driving a boat which is a cabin version with the heating on, driving in colder climates. I personally like extending the season. I'm of course very busy during the summer, but I have plenty of time in winter time, and I like to drive my own Oxapart 28 cabin with the heating on, which is just a great setup. But again, if you open up the window, you let the sun come in and you have an open boat, it's really practical and easy. So with that, I'd like to wrap this up. Please keep following our other videos. I hope to be doing a lot more. And please, if you have any questions, leave your remarks below the video. But for now, thank you for watching. I hope you enjoy the season, and I hope to see you at Schippers Watersport in Aalsmeer.